Well, praise his holy name. Well, glory be to God. Well, it's offering time. Hallelujah. We're here to give unto the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, giving the ministry, praise God, so he can take our seeds that we sow in love into the kingdom and cause us to reap of love in the kingdom. Why? Because we give because we love God and love people. Hallelujah. So that's why I tithe and that's why I give. Praise his holy name. Man, we're just so thankful that Jesus makes a way for us to be able to be blessed financially so we can give more to his kingdom to bless all over the world and our community. Praise his holy name. Man, don't forget that every fourth Sunday is Mission Sunday, and any month we have a fifth Sunday, it's Stretch Offering Sunday. So, man, just be praying, you know, to the Father and ask him to give you money to give into those times. It's only four times a year we have Stretch Offering, and then every month we have missions. But just remember, you know, John chapter 15, verse 7 says, if you abide in me and my words abide in you, you can ask what you will and you shall receive it. So that's what I base my giving on. I ask him, you know, for extra money to send to me so that I can give extra into his kingdom. And I just believe that his word's true. And if I do what his word says, he'll do what his word says. Hallelujah. So don't be speaking things against you being able to give into his kingdom. If something arises and an offering happens and you can't give, say, well, praise God, Lord, I don't know what happened this time, but I'm just thankful that next time I'm going to have plenty enough money to give. And bind the devil from interfering with your money and your finances and command him to take his hands off of it, because that's more your responsibility than God's, because he's done gave me and you all the power to take care of that. So I bind the enemy from stopping the finances that belong to the people that will give into the kingdom and give to True Christian Fellowship. I command you to take your hands off the money that belongs to our church. And I thank you, Lord, the money's coming in to build our church and to buy a van for fellowships. Hallelujah. And for the teens and the other people to have it to drive so everybody can ride together. And I thank you, Lord, for it in Jesus' holy name. Amen. Well, don't forget, you know, just write on your envelope your full address. Write on your envelope what place you want the money to go into. And there's three things that ain't on here in that stretch offering. So anytime you put in the stretch offering, you just write stretch on here somewhere. And anytime you put into the new church or building, just write new church. And anytime you put into the van, just write van on there. And we'll, you know, when we get new ones, we'll have that added on probably. But we're just thanking the Lord for taking care of every situation, every circumstance in our church, always coming through, and he always shows out. Hallelujah. So, Father, we just thank you right now. We praise you right now. We give you glory right now. We lift up our offerings to worship you from here, and we're thanking you that you're doing things above what we could even ask or think. And we give you all praise for meeting every need in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, praise the Lord Jesus. It's Wednesday night, the first Wednesday of February. Man, time is just flying by. Hallelujah. Already 1 month gone in 2021. We are close to the return of our Savior Jesus Christ. Man, I'm so happy to be a child of the living God in these days right now. Man, just so thankful to be his. Well, tonight we're going to talk about healing. Amen. A lot of people out there in the body of Christ are suffering from sickness, disease, pain, you know, and Jesus has promised us healing power to flow in our body, to flow through us, to heal us. And, you know, I quote out of Psalms 91 a lot, no plague shall come nigh my dwelling. And I just believe that. You know, and I say no accident shall befall me. I confess, you know, that I'm not going to hit no animals, and no animals are going to hit my vehicles to cause any harm, because I don't want to harm God's creation. Amen. And I don't want my vehicles to be harmed. I'm living a good life. Hallelujah. I'm enjoying life. And tonight we're going to talk about healing, because it's not enjoyable to live sick and diseased and hurting. No, we have to live according to his word and believe what he said, and it will come to pass. Well, let's go to Psalms chapter 41. I'm reading that the Amplified Version of the Bible. Hallelujah. And Psalms 41 and verse 3 says, "The Lord will sustain, refresh, and strengthen him on his bed of languishing." In other words, you in a you done had to be put to bed because of your sickness and or disease or pain. Well, the Bible says the Lord will sustain you, refresh you, and strengthen you. Hallelujah, on your bed of languishing. All his bed you, O Lord, will turn, change, and transform in his illness. Man, God can turn everything around no matter what me and you are going through. No matter what attacks us, no matter what comes against us, God can turn it around. You just got to look to him that he's the one that will deliver you. Like it says there in verse 1, blessed, happy, fortunate, to be envied is he who considers the weak and the poor. The Lord will deliver him in the time of evil and trouble. Amen. If you look out for people, you know, that are weak and poor, and you take care, be led by the Spirit, and help people, you know, that need help, he said you should be happy and fortunate. And verse 2 says, the Lord will protect him and keep him alive. He shall be called blessed in the land, and you will not deliver him to the will of his enemies. He will not deliver us to the will of our enemies. When we put first people, put first God, put first people that are poor, that are weak, and we look after them, he promises me and you that he will watch over us. Amen. He will watch over us. He will be there to sustain us. That's what God promises. So I'm going to trust him that he's going to take care of me. I'm going to trust the Master. Hallelujah, that he's watching over me and he will take care of me. Well, let's go to Psalms 147 and verse 3. Psalms 147 and verse 3. It says, he heals the brokenhearted and binds up their wounds, curing their pains and their sorrows. God does it. He heals the brokenhearted. He's already healed us in Christ. He binds up our wounds in Christ. He cures our pains and our sorrows by what Jesus did for us on the way to the cross and at the cross. Jesus took care of all of it. In Christ, I'm healed. In Christ, I'm filled. In Christ, I obey his word and do what his word says. Amen? It's in Christ. Praise God, it's in Christ. We got to learn to trust him. You know, the Lord will do what he says he will do, that he will take care of us because he said he would take care of us. He said he would heal the brokenhearted. He said he binds up our wounds. He's curing their pains and their sorrow. You out there today in pain? He said he's curing it. And at the cross, he already cured it. Amen? We just have to receive it from what he said he will do. When things he says in the word and we're not walking in it, it's just because we really don't believe what he's saying. We can say we believe it, but if it ain't working, we just ain't believing it. There's some doubt there. We are considering the physical senses somehow or another. We're looking at the pain, we're looking at it, and we're letting it win instead of looking at the word and letting it win. Knowing that his word has been forever settled in heaven and it can't lie, we got to have more faith than that than we do the actual things we can see, feel, taste, touch, and hear. Man, we got to know God's word is more powerful than the circumstances around us, that this world that we can see. His word is more powerful. Hallelujah. Let's go to Exodus. We're looking at the Old Testament, a few things here. Exodus chapter 23. Let's go to Exodus chapter 23 and verse 25. Exodus 23 and 25. I did it in reverse and went to 25. Hallelujah. Now 23:25. Praise God, man. He just wants me and you to trust in what he said. And if he spoke it, he can bring it to pass. If he says he cures you, then he cures you. If he says he heals you, he healed you. Amen. Verse 23, verse 25 said, you shall serve the Lord your God. He shall bless your bread and water. And he said, I will take sickness from your midst. I mean, that's what God has told me and you. Are we going to believe what he said or not? You say, well, there's sickness in my midst. Well, start confessing the word that God said He takes sickness from the midst of me and command that sickness to leave your household and get away from you and get out of your body. And believe the word is more powerful than what's happening in your body. Hallelujah. Just believe the word is more powerful. The word's coming through for you. Hallelujah. The word's showing up for you. The word cannot fail. It's God's message to me, and it cannot fail because He said it. He said He would take sickness from me, so therefore He took sickness from the midst of me, out of my household, away from me. Amen. Well, praise God. Man, these scriptures are just alive to me. How about you? They alive and well. Let's go to Isaiah chapter 58. Isaiah 58. Praise God. Isaiah 58 and verse 8. Says, then shall your light break forth like the morning, and your healing, your restoration, and the power of a new life shall spring forth speedily. And if you notice there, it says then. Well, what is then? He's talking about after you've come out of fasting and after you divided your bread with the hungry and bring the homeless poor into your house. When you see them naked, you cover them and hide not yourself from the needs of your own flesh and blood. You take care of people. In the New Testament, I say be led by the Spirit of what to do and don't go against His word. And take care of people when He leads you to take care of people. Now, He said if you see a Christian hungry or naked, you're supposed to take care of them. If you have the means to take care of them, you're supposed to do it. There ain't no praying in that. But in other people, be led by the Spirit and do what He says to do. Then He says, if you do what He says to do, you're led by His Spirit. You help people. He tells you to help them. Then shall your light break forth like the morning, and your healing, your restoration, and the power of a new life shall spring forth speedily. Man, you want to get healed quickly? Obey God and do what He says. Believe that He said He'd take sickness from the midst of you. Believe that, stand on that, and tell your body to line up with that. And you'll see it come forth speedily. There's a way of getting healing. The Bible says we can lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. A lot of people put their faith in that, but your faith in that is you get healed, but if you get healed and you let it back in 2 or 3 weeks later, it comes back on you and it's worse on you because now you got doubt in there that it's going to stay there. You put your faith in people laying hands on you. No, put your faith in His word that He said He'll take sickness away from you. Believe that and then tell your body to line up with Jesus said, the Father said, the Holy Ghost said, that sickness shall be taken from the midst of thee. So get out of my house, sickness. Get out of my body because my body is the house of the Holy Ghost. Now get away from me and stay away from me in Jesus' name. Well, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. The rest of the verse says, your righteousness, your rightness, your justice, your right relationship with God. See, that's what's wrong with a lot of people. They don't have a right relationship with God. Man, they want God to do everything for them, be faithful to them, but they don't want to be faithful to Him. They don't want to be faithful to what He tells them to be faithful to. They just want Him to be faithful in everything. Well, you know, once you become in covenant, it works both ways. Hallelujah. That's why people end up walking away from God, because they think He ain't faithful to them. But He is always faithful. But sometimes you have to reap what you're sowing because God has to take His hands off of you because you won't obey Him and do what He says. And you're praying is just for naught because you're praying amiss because you're just praying for fleshly gains. Instead of submitting yourself to His holiness and walking according to holiness and righteousness and doing what He said and following His word so that He can come through for you every single time. Amen? Well, praise God anyway. It says, shall go before you, conducting you to peace and prosperity, and the glory of the Lord shall be your rear guard. Man, the glory of the Lord watches over the rear side of you. Hallelujah. He takes care of you. I know I taught the putting on the armor of God, and there's nothing for the rear, but I always use this as my rear, that God watches over my rear, the backside of me. His glory is there. The glory of the Lord is my rear guard. He watches over me, my backside. You got the glory of the Lord all over you. Can't nothing penetrate you from the evil one. Hallelujah. That's what we need to do, is we need to stay focused on Him and what He's saying and following Him so His glory can rest on us, so sickness and disease can't rest on us and can't come in us. But every plague that comes at you dies because you've been vaccinated from on heaven. From heaven. Vaccinated from on high. Hallelujah. And the glory of the Lord's there. And you have a power of a new life in you. You've been restored. And you shall speedily recover from anything that attacks you. Hallelujah. Because you know who God is. You follow Him. You're following His will and His way and doing what He's saying. Amen. Let's go back to Psalms chapter 30. Psalms chapter 30 and verse 2. Hallelujah. Psalms 30 and verse 2. Praise God. Man, His word is delicious. Oh Lord my God, I cried to You and You have healed me. A lot of people say, man, I've cried to God a lot. And I ain't got healed. It's because you ain't been crying in faith. No, you got to cry to Him knowing that God is the one, the only one that can heal you. How did David start into this? Well, in verse 1 he said, I will extol You, O Lord, for You have lifted me up and have not yet my foes rejoiced over me. O Lord my God, I cried to You and You have healed me. Verse 3, O Lord, You have brought my life up from Sheol, the place of dead. You have kept me alive that I should not go down to the pit, the grave. Man, he's giving all the praise to God and he's worshiping Him. Then he says, sing to the Lord, all ye saints of His, and give thanks at the remembrance of His holy name. Man, you got to believe that God is there. He's going to take care of you and watch over you. You got to learn to praise Him and magnify Him because of what He has done for you. Hallelujah. Sing to Him because you're crying out to Him for healing. And you sing to Him and worship Him because He's the healer. A lot of people, you know, they seek the healing and don't seek the healer. Well, if you get the healer, you're getting the healing. So concentrate on the healer and worship and magnify Him and praise Him and glorify Him. Man, sing unto the Lord, O ye saints. Sing unto Him, thanking Him that when you cried out to Him, He healed your body. He set you free. He brought you from sickness to health. He brought you from pain to pain-free. And the Lord, you know, put on my heart, you know, the first of the year to be saying, I live in a pain-free body. I live pain-free life. And I've been confessing it. I believe, God, that it's activating in my body. In my body, the pain is leaving little by little. And I'm believing God, and I'm singing the joy unto Him. I enjoy living a pain-free life. How about you? Glory be to God. I cried unto the Lord and He healed me. I cried unto Jesus and He healed me because His word says by His stripes I'm healed. So I believe what His word says. Hallelujah. I believe His word cannot lie. Glory be to God. Let's go to Matthew. Matthew chapter 9. You say, well, I've been prayed for by the best. Well, get in the word and believe His word. Confess His word. And receive His word with thanksgiving. Receive His word with thanksgiving. He said He healed you, then receive that with thanksgiving, thanking Him for it. Hallelujah, man. Just learn to worship Him and magnify Him for what He's done. Don't go by how you feel. Don't go by what it looks like. Go by His word says you're healed and set free. So therefore I'm going to praise Him because of what His word says. Hallelujah. Matthew 9:35 says, and Jesus went about all the cities and villages, teaching in their synagogues and proclaiming the good news. The good news, the gospel of the kingdom. The good news and gospel of the kingdom. What's the good news? I've come to give you life and that life to enjoy. And if you're living an enjoyable life, it don't have sickness and disease in it. He said, I've come to do that. Curing all kinds of disease and every weakness and infirmity. You notice right there, he said every, you ain't got nothing going on in your life right now that Jesus didn't know about and didn't already take care of. He just waiting for me and you to step up in faith, believe what His word says, confess out of our mouth what His word says, receive what His word says, and don't consider the physical senses, and speak it until it comes to pass and mine in your life. I'm speaking His word every day till it comes to pass in my life. And you got to have faith like a dog with a new bone. He ain't turning that bone loose. And you shouldn't turn the word loose just because you're still hurting, just because things are still going on, just because the doctor keeps giving you a report. No, you stand on the word that by his word I'm healed. And you believe that and quit saying things out of your mouth that go contrary to that. Because he said you'll have what you say. And that's why most of you are still sick and diseased, afflicted and pain in your body, because you're still speaking it instead of speaking, no, the Lord said he will rescue me and he will take sickness out of the midst of me. Glory, out of my house he will remove sickness. Glory be to God. So I'm believing him. I'm going to follow his work and do what he says, because he has healed every kind of sickness and disease. So therefore, what I'm facing, he's already healed it. He's done it. So I'm believing he done it then. He can do it now. It's already done according to his word. Man, praise God. I'm excited about Jesus and seeing miracles happening in these last days. People come into our church and just get set free by his power. Hallelujah. We believe in that for every service. Glory, Luke chapter 8 and verse 50 said, but Jesus, on hearing this, answered him, do not be seized with the alarm or struck with fear. Simply believe in me is able to do this, and she shall be made well. Man, you got to understand here, Jesus was on his way to heal his daughter, and he got caught up by the woman, you know, with the issue of blood, and she got healed, and the crowd, they come and said, well, your daughter, you know, she's already dead. And Jesus said, man, don't worry about that. Don't worry about what they say. Don't listen to that bad report. Listen to me. Jesus heard this, and on hearing this, he answered him, do not be seized with alarm or struck with fear. I mean, what would you do if they come and said, your daughter, they say she's around 12 years old. What would you have done if they come and said, your 12-year-old daughter that you came to get Jesus to come and heal, and on your way there, he got detained, distracted by somebody else that needed healing. And why that happened, somebody come and said, don't worry them no more. Your daughter's dead. Don't you think that would be an opportunity? Do you be seized with fear? Have you went to the doctor before and you're battling something and he says, well, you need another operation, and you're seized with fear? Jesus tells me and you not to be seized with fear. He tells me and you to only believe. Believe that he's bigger than anything the devil, the doctor, anybody can add on to the circumstance. Well, I hurt my back. I had a surgery. Now you got to have another surgery. Just keep believing God until you heal. And if the Holy Ghost tells you, go ahead and have the surgery if that's where your faith is. But get to a place by hearing the message that come from the lips of the Messiah himself, that you can believe him, that what he said in his word concerning healing is for you. And believe it and accept it and receive that healing in your body so you can walk according to what the Lord has said concerning healing. His will is to heal. So receive that and believe it and quit considering the physical circumstances and situations. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's go to James chapter 5, verse 16. And, you know, we went on this last week. Believe it was last week or the week before that we went to this verse too. And it's right here is just it's the same thing. It's for healing. Hallelujah. You got wherever your faith is, your faith's here, then this is what you need to do if it's here. Confess to one another, therefore, your faults, your slips, your false steps, your offenses, your sins, and pray also for one another that you may be healed. Man, you got to believe God that you're healed. Hallelujah. But what he's telling us here, if there's any sin in your life, you need to get rid of that. You need to get that sin out of your life so you can be healed. Ask the Lord, examine. Tell him to examine you. Examine yourself with the word. Are you in sin? Get rid of that sin. Get rid of those slips, those false steps, so that you can be healed. And pray also for one another that you may be healed and restored to the spiritual tone of mind and heart, that earnest, heartfelt, continued prayer of a righteous man makes tremendous power available, dynamic in its working. Man, it's time to get to praying and believing God and not considering physical senses. Get people, hook up with people that know how to get in touch with heaven. Don't keep getting the same people to pray for it. They're walking in sin, and sin's there, and it's blocking it from happening. No, get the sin out of your life so God can take care of you and get hooked up with people that are walking according to righteousness and holiness, and let God come through for you, heal your body, and set you free. Hallelujah. And if you got faith in verse 15, call on the elders of the church. Or verse 14, if anyone's sick of me, call on the elders of the church. We went over that a couple of weeks ago. Hallelujah. Last week about walking by faith. Well, you got to have faith then that when I call on the elders and they lay hands on me, I'm going to be sick. If I'm going to church and I'm sick, I'm going to say as soon as, if I was a member of our church, I would say as soon as Pastor Robert lays hands on me, I'm going to be completely healed. And I would say that all week until it happened. If it's Wednesday or Thursday and I'm fighting sickness, then I'm going to say it all week. Man, as soon as Pastor Robert touches me, lays hands on me, I'm going to be completely healed. Hallelujah. And then when I say, man, anybody here need to be prayed for, your hand go up and say, man, Pastor Robert, as soon as you lay hands on me, I'm going to be healed. See, that's faith. Believing that you're going to get what you have confessed that you're going to get from the Lord. That you believe it. Amen? You believe it. You believe what the Master says. Hallelujah. Man, let's go to Isaiah 53. Isaiah 53, praise God. Let's go to Isaiah 53. Hallelujah. Man, this word is just delicious to me. Ain't it to you? Man, I just enjoy hearing the word over and over and over again. And we're going to look at verse 3, 4, and 5. Praise God. Verse 3 said, he was despised and rejected, forsaken by men, a man of sorrows and pains, acquainted with grief and sickness, and like one from whom men hide their faces, he was despised, and we did not appreciate his worth or had any esteem for him. Man, nobody didn't want to have nothing to do with Jesus when he was on the cross. They said he couldn't be recognized as a man. They beat him so bad. And he did that for me and you. Verse 4 says, surely he has borne our griefs, sicknesses, weakness, and distresses. Surely he bore them. If he bore them, you don't have to. Surely he bore them. He bore your sicknesses. He bore it. He bore your weaknesses. And he carried our sorrows and pains of punishment, yet we ignorantly considered him stricken, smitten, and afflicted by God as if with leprosy. No, we didn't. He wasn't stricken by God. He was stricken by our sin. Our sin was put upon him. Our sickness and disease was put upon him. And if it was put upon him to carry, then me and you don't need to carry. He did all that for me and you. Then it says in verse 5, but he was wounded for my transgression. He was bruised for my guilt and iniquities. The chastisement needful to obtain peace and well-being for us was upon him. And with his stripes, that those wounds that wounded him, we are healed and made whole. We are healed. Are healed. That's past tense. We are healed. Hallelujah. Now let's turn over here to 1 Peter. Y'all knew where I was going. 1 Peter chapter 2. 1 Peter chapter 2, hallelujah. 1 Peter 2, 24, remember, he was wounded for my transgressions. The chastisement of my peace was upon him. And by his stripes we are healed. In chapter 2, verse 24, says, he personally bore our sins in his own body on the tree. He personally did that. Is on an altar and offered himself on it. Man, he offered himself on an altar for me and you. He did that. Offered his body on an altar for me and you. But we may die, cease to exist to sin, and live to righteousness. See, he did that so me and you could die, cease to exist from sin. So if me and you are walking in sin, it's totally against what he did for us. Because he did it so me and you could cease to exist, die to sin and cease to exist to sin. So we could die, cease to exist from sin and live to righteousness. Righteousness, praise God. Righteousness, hallelujah. Man, we got to learn how to walk after righteousness in Christ. Hallelujah. Walk after that righteousness. How do you do it? You obey him. So he came, you know, gave himself, offered himself on the altar so we might die, cease to exist from sin, and live to righteousness. And by his wounds, you have been healed. So that's already been healed according to Jesus. Jesus done did all he gonna do about mine and your healing. It's up to me and you to believe it and quit considering the physical circumstances, quit considering the pain, quit considering the cough, quit considering the sneezing, quit considering the headache, the fever, quit considering the joint hurting, quit considering the swelling, quit considering the heart beating out of rhythm, quit considering the kidneys hurting, quit considering pain in your body no matter what it is, quit considering that and start considering that Jesus Christ came and took my and your transgressions away. He made us dead to sin, and by his wounds we have already been healed. Man, believe that. Receive that and believe what he's saying. Believe what he's saying. He talked about healing throughout the whole Bible, praise God, about being healed and walking according to his word. Let's go to Matthew 8:17. These last, you know, three here, if y'all have ever followed me or got my, where I teach you about healing and stuff and about you need to take this and take that, then you know that these right here are on the list that you should be confessing. And in Matthew chapter 8 and verse 17, it says, "And thus he fulfilled what was spoken by the prophet Isaiah." See, this is a fulfillment of the prophet Isaiah prophesied. Jesus came and fulfilled it. And that prophecy was that Jesus fulfilled was he himself took in order to carry away. Now, when something gets carried away, it's gone. So Jesus himself took in order to carry away our weaknesses, infirmities, and bore away our diseases. Man, Jesus came to take away your sickness, pain, disease, any plague or anything. He carried it away. He came in order to carry it away. Himself took it away from you. In order to carry it away, he took it. It's gone as far as he's concerned. It's gone, taken away from you. And if any of you's ever, you know, got my thing here that you confess. If you ain't got it, you need to get it. You need to confess these. Praise God. These are healing confessions. You know, we just did 8:17, 1 Peter 2:24, Isaiah 53:5. Then Acts 10:38 says how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and power, who went about doing good and healing all who were oppressed of the devil, for God was with him. All who were oppressed. So sickness and disease is an oppression. Luke 10:19 said, "Behold, I give you the power to tread on serpents and scorpions, and over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt me." I confess that for pain to get out of my body, that nothing shall by any means hurt me. 1 Peter 5:7, after you've believed God that all this sickness and disease and pain in your body is taken away, live carefree before God, because he's most careful for you, with you. God loves me so much, he cares so much about me, he wants me to live carefree before him. How you doing? Oh, I'm living carefree. Can you really say that? Can you really say that you're living carefree? And then that's the message part of it. Then the Amplified person says, casting your whole care, all your anxieties, all your worries, all your concerns, once and for all on him, for he cares for you affectionately and cares about you watchfully. That's what's wrong with a lot of you that still have the sickness in you. You still have pain in you. It's staying there. It's manifesting in your body. You know why? Because once and for all, you haven't cast it on Jesus and got rid of it. Hallelujah. You need to, if you got pain, you're going on anything in your body, you need to have those confessions that I've passed out at church and sent to people, and you need to be believing God and confessing them and doing what they say. Hallelujah. And getting rid of all that doubt and unbelief in your life by hearing what Jesus said that came from the lips of the Messiah himself, building faith in you, doing it every day. You take that medicine 3 times a day, don't you? You need to be reading that paper I gave you at least 3 times a day until that healing power manifests itself in your body. Well, glory to God. I hope if you're sick, you get healed from this message. I hope this has been a blessing to you and brought faith to you concerning healing. Now, walk in health in these last days because Jesus provided health for you. So walk in it. Let people see you walking in health and testify about what the Lord has done. Look what the Lord has done. He healed my body. He touched my mind. He saved me just in time. And I'm going to praise His name and tell people Jesus healed you and set you free. Let them know what He's done for you. Man, we love y'all. We'll see y'all Sunday morning at 10 a.m. Well, we're so thankful. Man, it is altar call time. Praise God. So if you're here today, you know, if you listen to the message today, and we're just so thankful that you joined in with us today. And if you need to give your whole life to Jesus right now, we want you to repeat after me. Say, Father, I come to you today. I believe your word. I've been convicted today of sin in my life. Lord, I thank you for rescuing me from my sins. I thank you for shedding your blood and presenting an offering to the Father that took away all my sin. Now, Father, I believe right now in Jesus. Jesus, I confess you as my Lord. Father, I believe in my heart that you raised Jesus from the dead. And according to your word right now, I'm born again. Now, Father, I've believed in him. I'm relying on clinging to and trusting in him. Now, Father, make me a disciple. Show me Jesus' doctrine. And let someone put me under someone that'll teach me how to follow his doctrine and live in accordance with it. If you don't have a church home, make your church home True Christian Fellowship and come and let Pastor Robert be over you in the Lord. And I'll teach you how to follow Jesus through the teachings of Christ. Amen. Now, if you've given your whole life to Jesus, man, just send me if you got my phone number, send me a text. If you don't, then send me an email. Just please take the time and send me an email at godisslapawesome@bellsouth.net. So I can give a praise report on the air of what God's did in your life. Amen. And that goes for all y'all watching that's in the church and God's doing things for you. I've been telling you now to send me praise reports through my email address or text me. And if you got one and ain't done it, then people are missing out on hearing your report because the Bible says, make your deeds known among the people. So if he's done anything for you, you need to let me know through email or through a text so I can do it on the next service and say, man, we just want to praise God for God doing this in so-and-so's life. Amen? Man, we're so thankful. And Lord, right now we're believing that your word says we can lay hands on the sick and they'll recover. We can send your word and people can get healed. So right now, if there's any problem in your body, the doctors gave you a bad report, no matter what it is, right now I ask you to put your hand on that. I'm going to stretch forth my hand. I'm believing right now in Jesus' name. The anointing is flowing through this, coming into you wherever your hand is, and we're driving out that demonic force that's trying to attack itself to your body, and you're going to walk totally healthy, healed, and whole. You're a healed woman in a healthy body. You're a healed man in a healthy body. Now just receive that and receive it with thanksgiving and praise God that you've been delivered from whatever that circumstance is. Amen. And just let him know how thankful you are that you're walking in victory in Jesus. Amen. And we're just so thankful for y'all. We can't wait to see y'all again. And we love y'all so much. And we praise God for you. We praise God for you. We're so thankful for you. Hallelujah. And don't forget, if you're doing your offering by mail, don't forget to send it. If you're doing it by the church, drop it off, put it in the slot. And we're so thankful for y'all, your faithfulness. And we praise God for you. And we thank God for you. Amen. And we thank God for more coming. In Jesus' name, amen.